almost 5,000 stores blanketing the United States, millions pass through Walmart's doors every day. But for some Americans, this isn't just a superstore, it's a place to call home.
Morning, Joe.
Morning, guys.
How are you?
Okay. How are you?
In Flagstaff, Arizona, Joe Thorpe is waking up at Walmart.
Want to go and get a coffee?
Yeah, sure.
Let's do it.
I'm game.
Joe is homeless and has lived in the Walmart car park for the past 7 years.
Yeah, it's cheaper when you just get a refill.
Joe is one of tens of thousands of people taking advantage of a little publicised Walmart policy, allowing travellers to pull up in their car parks and stay the night for free.
You know, it can get pretty harsh up here. I've been here, I know. I've had my car, you know, without that, I never would have made it, you know. I'd have to be in a shelter, and I don't like the shelters.
Joe travelled to Arizona for work, but a back injury left him jobless and on the streets. Unable to get Social Security, he's been forced to live out of his car.
A lot of homeless people aren't bad people, you know, they could be normal people. I thought I was halfway normal, you know, before I started living this way.
While Joe has nowhere else to go, makeshift Walmart communities like this one are attracting Americans from all walks of life.
I do a mix in the mornings. My unsweetened cereal.
In another corner of the car park, Nolan Conway is also starting his day at Walmart.
Good morning, I'm good, thank you. I'm a photographer and I'm doing a little project called Waking Up at Walmart.
This professional photographer is so intrigued by the Walmart phenomenon, he's been documenting its car park communities for the New York Times.
This overnight culture here is for everyone. You know, you have people there out of who are there out of necessity, and you have people there who are just out of convenience, and they're both of their stories are, you know, equally valid in this. And maybe put one hand back.
Hal and Jackie are typical grey nomads. Staying at Walmart is ingrained in the RV culture as a cheap and effective way to see the country.
So we're going to make this loop. Go up California and back over to the Dakotas. We like Walmart. Mm-hmm. I mean, yeah. We like it a lot.
Yeah.
It's convenient,
mm-hmm.
And you got everything you need inside the store.
But most here have no choice but to stay.
Can you bring your cigarette up to your mouth?
Since the housing crisis began, the world's biggest company is becoming better known as a safe haven for America's homeless. No one knows exactly how many people are living out of their cars, but with well over a million on the streets, these car parks have become de facto shelters.
Flagstaff's good, it's just a little cold in the winter. It drops, you know, below, it gets around 20 below out here, so it's a little cold, colder than you want to be.
Paul sleeps on the ground next to his friend's truck and has been living like this on and off for 3 years. Today, he's earning some much-needed cash as Nolan's assistant.
Arizona is a right-to-work state. They call it a right-to-work-for-nothing state.
So can you survive in America on minimum wage these days?
No, absolutely not.
Paul's not the only one stuck in a rut. A week ago, Michelle and Brandon swapped their car for this old school bus, and it's already broken down.
So we had to pull the whole radiator out, drop a new one in, and hope for the best, huh?
Michelle and Brandon have travelled from California with their daughter Enola in search of a better life.
This is where my cousin sleeps. Our bedroom's in the back, so everything's tied in with a chain or strap or bungee, so nothing shifts.
Where are your chickens?
Right there.
Right here.
And this is Ruby.
That's Ruby, that's my hen.
Michelle and Brandon say they fled California, worried that they'll lose custody of their baby. Three of their children have already been taken by social services.
They're so racist out there, and so we call it the war on the homeless. They're so anti-homeless out there. It's a war, okay? And people like me that are sober and don't do drugs and just want to get off the streets and have a home and do right by themselves, you know, as soon as we start getting those things going for ourselves, they will do whatever they can to come in and fuck you up.
For the time being, all Michelle can think about is getting her family back together.
I don't know legal stuff. I don't. I'm having to learn all this stuff the hard way. And so we've just been looking for loopholes how to get our family back together any way we can. You know, even if we have to piece it together one baby at a time, so be it.
Local charity worker Richard Dufresne has been watching the swelling numbers of Walmart's homeless, and last year he decided to help out.
And we try to make it between 500 and 700 calories. That's enough calories to keep somebody going for a day. And then invite. Everybody's invited to our church.
Do you get many takers?
Nope, not one.
Every summer, homeless from elsewhere in Arizona flood into Flagstaff for its cooler weather, causing the local shelters to overflow. And with virtually no public housing, this car park is often their only resort.
I think it's a crossroad for travelers, and I think people come here looking for work and they can't find it. A lot of them move on down the road, but a lot of them are stuck now because they've gone through their resources.
For years in Flagstaff, sleeping overnight in your vehicle was technically illegal. But recently, the city's mayor changed the law.
I think I'd rather have them in a Walmart parking lot than out by the side of the road or off the highway somewhere where, you know, they're not as well protected. And there just doesn't seem to be any trouble with spending the night in Walmart. And I saw no reason why the city should prohibit it.
In this place, the motor caught on fire.
Oh, really?
Yes, it caught on fire.
While they were working on it?
Yes. My friend went to start it, and it shot out some flames about like so, and they had to put it out. I was so scared. This whole place was...
Liz Souza is from Washington State and a regular at the Flagstaff Walmart. Every year, she drives south for the Arizona summer.
I mean, this is convenient for me to be up here in the summertime and have a place where I could park, where I don't have to be stuck with paying, you know, rent to somebody.
Liz is an aspiring actress, and from her RV, she's chasing the Hollywood dream.
Okay.
That's professionally taken. I get some of my prints done here at Walmart because it's cheaper. I really don't have anybody that's coordinating me because everybody is... Usually what I do is I go on the internet and I have a list of casting directors and I send myself out with resumes.
Mm-hmm.
And if I hear anything back, then I hear something. But I've been doing this for years and I've never heard anything.
I haven't heard anything. How's it going, Joe?
For those down on their luck, this Walmart car park is now a welcome refuge. But many, like Joe Thorpe, end up trapped here.
Have you seen this yet?
Yeah, in the magazine.
You saw the magazine.
Yeah, I got the magazine actually in the car.
Oh, you do?
Can
you pull it out?
Joe was photographed by Nolan last year.
About a year ago, huh?
Yeah, that's the old car,
the old beater.
Yeah, what was that? That was like the old station wagon?
88 Ford station wagon.
Yeah.
The car saved my tail, man, many times, you know?
Since his photo was taken, Joe's still on the waiting list for public housing.
I ain't getting no younger out here. Came out here when I was 46, I'm 55 now, and I feel it taking a toll on me, you know? I'm tired.
Joe is surviving on food stamps and the questionable charity of a local casino that provides free transport, food, and gambling chips to Flagstaff's down and outers.
Heck, they give you free food, a food voucher for the buffet and everything like this, and $15 in free play, and like I said, didn't cost nothing, and you get to play the slots or whatever, and I was winning money. And it's like, what the heck, man, this is cool. You know, it's not costly, I'm eating and everything. Well, I kind of got hooked after a while.
Joe's now addicted to gambling, but it gets worse. After test driving a new vehicle for a few free gambling chips, Joe was talked into trading in his truck for a new car he can't afford.
So what do your homeless friends think about the car?
Why am I still here? You know, it's like they figured, yeah, he's got a new car, man. He's going to get out of here, you know. He's moving up the ladder now. And I don't know, I'm still here. It's like, I don't know where else to go. I don't have no money to go, you know, anywhere else.
When he can scratch a few dollars for petrol, Joe escapes the Walmart crowds for a nearby forest. Like all the others stuck at Walmart, he's looking for a way to turn his life around.
This is something that, from being in the forest, you know, seeing them like this, and I just drew it like that way. But I could get better, you know, I'm like an amateur, you know. But with paint and that, I think I might be able to do better, you know, get where I could sell them.
With his new car and a place to park it, for the moment, Joe's okay. But time is running out. The casino wants its money, and he's likely to lose the car within weeks.
I used to have a life, and I think that's what makes it hard for me, is sometimes I feel guilty because of it, you know, being in this situation. But I'm not alone, you know. Anybody can go homeless. Everybody's, you know, one step away from that, actually.
With his luck running out, Joe faces an uncertain future. But for tonight, like for thousands of other Americans, Walmart is his home.